Axel Button used to be my favorite superhero, and he wears a mask, and he hides his identity. I think it perfectly suits me right now, because this is my very first speech, and you all don't know much about me. So here's my picture with the mask. And the back of my speech is a person behind the mask. I was born in Novosibirsk, but I grew up in CNA, and I actually wanted to become a financial, which is kind of lame, right? We all want to become a superhero or something like that. But actually, there is a story behind that. When I was at the kindergarten, I found a huge coin, which looked like a 20 tenge coin, and I grabbed it, and I went to a salesman, thinking that, okay, I'm going to get 6 to 7 chewing gums. But the lady told me that this coin was invalid. And I was like, how come, right? And brought that coin home, and showed it to my father. And my father told me, whoa, you are rich. I was like, how come? Yeah, one person told me that this coin was invalid, and the other one is telling me that this coin is precious. That is why I wanted to solve the mystery of that coin, and I decided I'm going to become a financial. Actually, the reason why the coin was precious, that coin was made of pure silver.
Oh.
Wow.
That was actually my plan. Yeah. But later on, you know, actually this dream was almost in the way of me becoming a student of Kazakh Turkish High School. As you know, to become a student of Kazakh Turkish High School, you have to pass 3 steps. The first one, you have to pass a test, yeah, on logic and your academic background. The other step was to, you know, go to that school. There was a 10-day camp, and be, you know, checked for your, you know, behavior and academic abilities, yeah, to learn. And the third step was actually an interview. So I got to that interview, and they asked me the easiest question possible, and they asked me, who you want to become? And the answer was, banker. The worst answer possible, right? Because all the teachers of Kazakh Turkish High School, they used to be volunteers, and they worked for greater good, and they wanted to become a banker. And the next question was, does it mean that you like money? And here I go, come on, that was the worst answer possible. So of course I told them, no. And they did not believe me. So the third question was, okay, if we give you $1 million, what would you do? And I told them that I'm going to give half of that money to the government. That's how I got to that place. Actually, my father still jokes. Like, he still jokes that, okay, when you're planning to become a millionaire and give up half of that money. Right? But anyway, at Kazakh Turkish High School, I was doing not so well at first, because I was good at math, but I was not good at languages. And, you know, I tried to improve, but it was very difficult. Later on, my family moved from Semi to Almaty, and that is where I got ambitious. Yeah, I learned how to become more efficient. Yeah, I learned how to be ambitious, and I learned what I wanted to do in my life. And basically, that was to become an entrepreneur. But lately, yeah, I thought, okay, I want to become an entrepreneur, but I have some academic background, so first I need to study. Yeah. And travel all over the world. And actually, I had a plan, and that plan worked well. And I actually became one of the best graduates of Aksai Kazakh Turkish High School. Then I got 3 scholarships. After that, I spent some time in the US. After that, I, you know, studied in Latvia. I worked in Spain. And finally, I passed an internship in Belgium. So I was kind of happy. Right? And in 2016, I found myself working for Almaty Management University, being an executive assistant to the director of MBA, and working with an international team, being responsible for accreditation and reaccreditation, and by the way, that is the most reputable accreditation in the business world. Yeah, I'm sure you know AMBA and WCSB, and that is the dream of Nazarbayev University and Himay, and they did not get that, right? We got that, so I'm proud of that, right? But anyway, when we were about to get that accreditation, yeah, actually I was really happy. Oh God, we're going to do that, but I was exhausted and I thought, maybe I'm going to get happy, right? But by that time, I was depressed. As soon as we get that accreditation, I did not get any feeling of happiness. I thought, okay, I think it is a call for change, and I need to persuade my dream. So it was about becoming an entrepreneur. So I quit and started a startup, got funding, yeah, went to British Technical University, and there was a demo day. Yeah, I learned how to code, I learned how to use UI and UX, right? And we got there, and I was in the future with Norio trying to present my, you know, achievements. But the problem was that actually we did not get funding, right? Nobody did. Yeah, so that is the problem of startups in Kazakhstan in general. But anyway, I got there and I thought, okay, I want to become an intern, I have an academic background, so I need to unite it somehow, right? And so that is why right now I'm doing PhD in innovation management. In conclusion, I would like to say, persuade your dreams, do not give up on yourself, and stay hungry, stay foolish. Thank you.